Ki Joo recently sat down for an interview with Hankookilbo, where she talked about her immersion into her character Gil Nak1, and how it had taken an emotional toll on her. See also, Jin Ki Joo shares how she and Jang Ki Young became comfortable with kiss scenes. She expressed her affection for the character, saying, "I kept asking the director, when will Nak1 become happy? Soompi. Display, news, English 0.300x250, BTF Soompi. Mobile, English 0.300x250, ATF The actress shared, "When we were filming the amusement park scene, it was finally the day that she was going on a happy date. I was physically smiling and laughing, but couldn't do the same internally. I would joke around with Jang Ki Young and the staff members, but I felt strange because I kept feeling melancholy." She laughed and said, "I told the director, the amusement park scene was hard for me, and he said had felt it as well. He told me, you should have enjoyed the date." Jin Ki Joo explained that she kept feeling this gloominess until around episode 11 and 12, but she didn't know why she felt that way at the time. She initially thought it was because of her stamina. However, because the episodes were postponed often due to World Cup, North Korea-US summit, and election coverage, she was able to get enough sleep and recharge. The actress laughed and commented that she even tried to eat more food, but that hadn't worked either. She continued, "I kept filming in this frustrated state. But one day, I was in the car reading my script on the way to film, and I started crying. There was a line where Jisoo asked me, 'Are you okay? Can you not remember your parents?' And it was so sad that I teared up. I realized it then. Thinking about it, Gil Nak1 would always say, 'I'm okay,' first before someone could comfort her and ask her if she was alright." Quote, Jin Ki Joo explained, "I thought that while she says that and she's energetic and strong, she must have wanted to be comforted herself. I texted the writer. I asked her, 'There's going to be a day when Gil Nak1 also lets her emotions loose, right?' The writer said, 'Has that in mind,' and that she was sorry. She told me that because the character held her emotions and suppressed them, there would eventually be a moment like that." The actress shared, "After texting the writer, my heart felt lighted just from receiving that reply. From then on, I felt much more refreshed and I became brighter on set as well. Eventually, it was all resolved in the last episode as she went on her ordinary dates. Right now, I've put all those emotions behind me. If you haven't already, check out the first episode of Come and Hug Me, below. Watch now, source."